Good morning everyone. Today we will start with organic chemistry subject in that chapter number 1, that is benzene and its derivative. So in that unit number 1, you will learn about different concepts of the aromaticity of the benzene, their different derivatives, different chemical reactions, preparations relating with the benzene. Okay, so now first we will go with the concept of the aromaticity. As we all know, the aromatic compound, we majorly known as a benzene as an aromatic compound, right? So first one is a benzene is a representative member of class of aromatic organic compound, which is isolated in 1825 by Michael Faraday. Okay, they are having a specific distinct order. And there are other organic compounds which are known to be associated with some of the order but are not classified as aromatic. Next one is structure of benzene. We all know the benzene having a molecular formula C6H6, which is having a high degree of unsaturation, but it does not go for the any unsaturated compounds reactions such as addition reactions, oxidations, reductions. Even they cannot give decoloration taste of bromine or as well as potassium permanganate, which is a confirmatory taste for unsaturated compound. So it is a highly characteristic of unsaturated compound. In fact, benzene undergoes substitution reactions. Reactions of the benzene with bromine in presence of pyridic bromide catalyst result in the formations of only one compound, that is bromophenyl or C6H5Br. This suggests that all the hydrogen atoms of the benzene ring systems are equivalent in nature. Their unusual behavior of benzene is attributed to that structure. Now, according to the Kekulé structure, in 1865, the Kekulé scientist proposed that the six-member ring structure of the benzene, where each carbon is attached to one hydrogen atom to satisfy the tetravalency of carbon. You can see here, this is the tetravalency of the carbon are satisfied. To satisfy further, he proposed the presence of three alternative double bonds in benzene ring, which changes their position rapidly. He also explained that two forms of benzene are exist in equilibrium and that cannot be isolated. You can see in this figure. You can see these are the three double bonds. See, three double bonds are changeable in both the structure. These all are one and two structures are equilibrium. Next, although the Kekulé structure satisfies the structural features of the benzene, he can also explain the equivalent nature of the hydrogen. As we earlier discussed about that, all the hydrogen atoms of the benzene ring system are equivalent in nature. So they are all having give a same reaction or same reaction mechanism to the specific electrophile, nucleophile or any Lewis acid or base. Next one is resonance structure. Benzene undergoes the resonance structure. It means the specific rotations of the pi bond, rotations of the electron. Right? Resonance theory gives the correct descriptions of the structure of the benzene, which state that whenever molecule is represented by two or more Lewis structure, it means their contributing structure. Any one of the structure alone is not able to explain the characteristic of one whole molecule. It should be in a hybrid in nature. So the actual structure in such case is a hybrid of all the contributing structure. And these contributing structures are called as resonance form, and these are hypothetically, which cannot be isolated. So these are represented by placing a double-headed arrow between them, and all the structures are said to be in a resonance with each other. Note that all the contributing structures are never in equilibrium, as these are not a real structure. Right? This for the benzene, major contributing structures are written. You can see here. this benzene ring system, there is a rotations of a pi bond. So they are having a number of structures of resonance structures are there. The actual hybrid structures has lower energy compared to either of contributing structure alone. Why? Because this decrease the energy of hybrid structure and which stabilize your molecule. That is known as resonance energy. So we can say that due to the resonating structure, the resonance energy is increased. The resonance energy is also termed as delocalization energy. Why delocalizations? Because resonance is nothing but there is a delocalization of the pi electron inside the ring system. Resonance is nothing but delocalization of pi electron. So benzene has a higher resonance energy as compared to other aromatic carbon. Next one is orbital structures of the benzene. As you can see in the figure, this is orbital structures of benzene. Experimentally suggests that the molecule of benzene has to be planar or with 6 carbon-carbon double length being the same. All the bond length is similar of the single and the double bond. The orbital picture of benzene explains the behavior of benzene in accurate way. So all the carbons of the benzenes are having a sp2 hybridization. This all the carbon are sp2 hybridized. Each carbon has 3 hybrid orbitals, 2 of which are used in formations of carbon-carbon sigma bond on either sides, and one of the hybrid orbitals are used in the formations of carbon-hydrogen sigma bond. This gives a planar skeleton with 6 carbon attached to each other in a cyclic manner. Right? So this all are cyclic nature of the benzene. You can see in this figure. All the carbon, they all are having a similar length, similar bond. Right? They all are having a hydrogen atom attached in a specific manner. Right? They all are having a 1p orbital which contains 1 pi electron. Right, so this all are relating with the resonating structure. Next one is the upper lobe and the lower lobe. This suggests that this upper lobe and this is the lower lobe of the benzene structure. This both are having electron in that nature. They contains pi electron cloud which is attached to the different derivative. So all the 6 carbon benzene are sp2 hybridized. Each carbon has 3 hybrid orbitals, 2 of which are used in the formations of carbon-carbon sigma bond. Each carbon also has a pure p orbital with unpaired electron. In all, these are 6 p orbital having 6 unpaired electron present in the same plane of the 6 member ring system. This 6 p orbital overlapping each other and form a pi electron cloud above and below the plane. Due to this overlapping, the 6 electron are shared equally among all the 6 carbon, and this is known as delocalization of pi electron. Due to this delocalization of pi electron, they will possess resonance structure, and due to resonance that stability is increased, that energy is also increased. So this is evident that double bonds are not localized between only any 2 carbons. It is a continuation process. It is a continuation delocalization of the pi electron. Next, this figure suggests that the specific length of the carbon-carbon bond, which state that the delocalization causes all 6 carbon-carbon double length to be same that is 1.39 angstrom. And the values lies in the between pure CC bond, double bond, that is 1.54 angstrom, and C double bond C bond length. It means first one CC, that is a single bond. Second one, that is a C double bond, that having a length 1.33. You can see that the bond length is decreased when there is a bond number is increased. Why? Because that stabilized your carbon atom. Whenever there is a number of bond is increased, that bond length is decreased. Benzene is thus represented as hexagon with circle inscriptite, where the circle represent delocalized pi electron. This is a specific structure of benzene, and its representations all are having a 120 degree bond angle one. Next one is the resonance energy. As we discussed earlier, different orbital structure which describes the delocalization of the pi electron, that will give a different resonating structure, and that resonating structures give a resonance energy to the benzene ring system. As a table suggests that this cyclohexene having a 1 pi bond, second cyclohexane 1,4-diene having a 2 pi bond, and third one is a hypothetically cyclohexane 1,3,5-triene. We are also considered as a benzene ring system. So you can see the inside heat of the hydrogenations. What is actually heat? What is actually resonance energy? So this resonance energy is fully dependable on number of pi bond into heat of hydrogenations of cyclohexene, that is minus 119.6. So as this table suggested that whenever the number of pi bond is increased, the heat of hydrogenation is also increased, right? So first cyclohexane having a minus 119.6, second diene, two double bond, minus 239.2, and the last benzene ring system having a minus 208 degrees Celsius resonance energy. So it is a highly observable. Next one is the characteristic of the benzene. This is discussion. Benzene is a cyclic planar molecule. All the carbons are sp2 hybridized, and the p orbitals available on each carbon contribute toward the continuations of pi electron and delocalization of the pi electron. So as we are also discussed here, like this, this all six p orbital having a 1-1 unshared pi electron, which present this two upper lobe and lower lobe cloud, and due to that cloud they are having a different resonating structure. They will possess delocalizations of the pi electron. This provides stability to the benzene and imparts the higher resonance energy. So retain the resonance energy, benzene should have higher number of delocalizations of pi electron. As a result, does not behave as an unsaturated system, does not undergo additions reactions. Although benzene is having an unsaturated compound, they will act as saturated compound, highly saturated compound. Why? Because of this delocalizations of the pi electron. Next, the most important, that is Hückel's rule and its aromaticity. We can consider any of compound that can be aromatic or not by Hückel's rule. This Hückel rule suggests the conformations of aromatic compound. If any compound follows the Hückel rule, it is considered as a aromatic compound. If does not follow, that cannot be considered as an aromatic compound. So in 1931, Hückel gave a rule for monocyclic compound, which state that cyclic compound containing 4N plus 2 delocalized pi electron exhibit aromatic compound. Now what that suggests? 4N plus 2. Now 4n plus 2, it is a number of delocalization pi electron. For an example, if n is equal to 0, for an example, n is equal to 0. So 4 into 0, 0 plus 2. That gives 2 delocalized pi electron. While there is a 2, 6, 10, 14, 18, 22, this all number we have given, it is called delocalized pi electron. So if any compound having this type of delocalized pi electron like 2, 6, 10, 14, 18 and 22, whatever that is, this give a aromatic compound. And if your compound give another of this number, they will act as a non-aromatic compound. In that end, the specific end number, it is act as a ring. Presence of ring in your compound. Suppose in your compound having a two ring system, you can consider n is equal to 2. So you can calculate it as that n is equal to 2. It means 4 into 2, 8 plus 2. It means 10. If you are having a 10 delocalized pi electron, it is considered as aromatic compound. Another one, the compound is said to be aromatic. It should have follow this different four rules. If this does not follow even one rule, it cannot be considered as aromatic compound. So any compound which have to under the category of aromaticity, they should have follow all these four statements. Now that first statement is your compound should be cyclic in a nature. If any compound having a non-cyclic in nature, it cannot be considered as aromatic compound. Next one, it is a planar. So all the carbon-carbon atom structure should be planar in a nature. In presence of sp2 hybridized carbons in the system imparts planarity. So for the planar structure, your carbon should have sp2 hybridized, right? Third one, it should exhibit continuous delocalizations of pi electron. Continuous delocalization pi electron is possible on each carbon of overlap. Fourth one, it should follow the Huckel's rule. It means 4n plus 2 statement. This 4n plus 2 number is 2, 6, 10, 14, 18 and 22. It is considered as aromatic. Rather than this, that cannot be considered as an aromatic compound, where n is a 0 or that can be a whole number. So n is a number of ring present in your compound. So for the aromaticity nature, your compound should follow all these four statement or this fourth rule. If any compound does not follow even single rule, that cannot be considered as aromatic compound. We can see for the further examples of different member of ring system, like 3-membered, 4-membered, 5-membered, 6, 7 and 8. And according to that, different member of ring system, we can consider this, that they can be considered as aromatic or not. Or if not aromatic, then why? Which are the different rules are there? Okay. So first one is aromaticity of 3-membered ring system. As we all know, this is a structure of cyclopropane. Yes. 3 carbon are there. Called as cyclopropene. Why propene? Because they are having a 1 double bond in that structure. Now according to this 4 rule, see in that 3-member ring system, cyclopropene, it is a cyclic in nature. Yes, they follow the first rule. It is a planar. Yes, because they all are, these two are hybridized, sp2 hybridized, double bond are present. Third one, it does not exhibit continuous delocalizations. One of the carbon in cyclic system is sp3 hybridized. So this p orbital is not available on the carbon for delocalizations. You can see here in the structure of cyclopropene, these two carbon double bond having a carbon are sp2 hybridized. But the upper carbon CH2 are there. So it is a sp3 hybridized. So due to this sp3 hybridized, they cannot go for the continuous delocalization of pi electron, right? So it does not follow the third rule. And the last one, obey the Huckel's rule. Why they are having obey the Huckel's rule? As the number of delocalized pi electron is 2. You can see here, they are having a one double bond. Each carbon having a 1 pi electron. So that delocalized pi electron is 2. So that obey the Huckel's rule. It is a cyclic in nature. It is a planar in nature. But due to does not exhibition the continuous delocalization of pi electron, it is not considered as aromatic compound. So cyclopropene is not aromatic, as all the conditions are not simultaneously satisfied. For the aromatic compound, that all the four rules are should be followed properly. Now next one, same thing regarding cyclopropene. This is cyclopropanyl cation, and next one is cyclopropanyl anion. Now you can consider here cyclopropanyl cation. You can see the structures are similar. Changes in that only positive and negative ion. Positive ion cation and anion is a negative ion. So first is it is follow the cyclic. Yes, it is a cyclic in nature. It is a planar. Yes, it is a planar. Why? Because they are having a cationic in structure. So they all are having a sp2 hybridized. You can see here. Third one, it exhibit continuous delocalizations. Why? Because all the carbon are sp2 hybridized. While in here, one carbon is sp3. But in case of cationic, they all are sp2 hybridized. So they can easily go for the delocalizations of pi electron. So they will possess resonance energy. And next one, they obey the Huckel's rule, because the number of delocalized pi electron is 2. Why 2? Why number of pi electrons is 2? Because they are having a one double bond. Right? One double bond, it means they are having a 2 carbon. Each carbon have 1 pi electron. So number of delocalized pi electron is 2. Okay, next one, in similar manner, cyclopropanyl anion. Now this anion, what does suggest? Cation having a positive ion, anion having a negative ion, it means extra A having a electron. So first, it is a cyclic in nature, it is a planar. Next, third one is exhibit continuous delocalizations. Why? In a similar, they all are having a sp2 hybridized. Thus, the sp orbitals are available for delocalizations. So they easily follow the first three rule. But in the last, does not obey the Huckel's rule. Why? As you can see in this figure, 2 pi electron, one from the carbon, second from the another double bond. And there is cyclopropanyl anion gives extra 2 pi electron. So as a total, does not obey the Huckel's rule, because the number of delocalized pi electron is 4. As our Huckel's rule suggests that number should be 2, 6, 10, 14, 18 and 22. There is no 4 number in a list. So that's why the cyclopropanyl anion does not follow the Huckel's rule. Due cyclopropanyl anion is not aromatic, as all these conditions are not satisfied, especially the last one. Next one is for the 4-member ring system. In that we have considered cyclobutadiene. As we can consider, this is a structure of cyclobutadiene. They are having a two double bond and having a 4 pi electron, right? So see the first, it follows the first, it is a cyclic in nature. Yes, it is a cyclic in nature. Planar, yes, because all the carbon are sp2 hybridized, it is a planar in a nature. Third one, it is exhibit continuous delocalizations. Why? Because all the carbons of the cyclic systems are sp2 hybridizations. Tuesday, p orbitals are available for delocalizations. But last, it does not obey the Huckel's rule. Why? Because the number of delocalized pi electron is 4, not 2 or 6. As for the obey of Huckel's rule, it should be between 2, 6, 10, likewise. So 4 number is not in the list, so it does not follow the Huckel's rule. So as cyclobutadiene is not aromatic, as all the conditions are not satisfied, right? Next one, aromaticity of the 5 member ring system. We have discussed 3 member ring system, in that cyclopropene, cyclopropene alkatiene, anion. 4 member ring system, in we have discussed cyclobutadiene. And next we are going for the 5 member ring system, that is cyclopentadiene. Okay, this is the structure of cyclopentadiene. Again, similar manner like cyclopropene, they are having a 1 sp3 carbon in a structure. Now let's see, first it is a cyclic in nature. Okay, it is follow the first statement. Second is a planar, yes. Third one, it does not exhibit continuous delocalizations. Why? Because in structures of cyclopentadiene, there is a 1 carbon which is sp3 hybridized. They are having a no double bonds are there. Thus, this p orbital is not available for delocalizations, so as they cannot follow the third statement. And the last one, it also not follow the Huckel's rule. Why? Because the number of delocalized pi electron is 4. As you can see, why the number of pi electron is 4? You can consider here, they are having a 2 double bond. Each carbon having a 2, each double bond having a 2 pi electron. So 2 double bond having a 4 pi electron. Right? So this is the example of cyclopentadiene. Now come to the different ionic statement of cyclopentane. So first one is cyclopentadienyl anion. Right? So this is the structure of cyclopentadienyl anion. Anion having a specific extra pi electron in that structure. So you can see, first statement, it is a cyclic in nature. Yes, it is a cyclic. Then second one is a planar. Yes, it's a planar in nature. Third one, it is a continuous delocalizations are there because all the carbon are sp2 hybridized. Why? Because it is a ionic form of cyclopentadiene rather than only simple cyclopentadiene molecule. Right? Because all the p orbitals are available for delocalizations. And they also possess resonance, and that resonance structures are available. You can see in that figure. But last one, let obey the Huckel's rule, as the number of pi electron is 6. Why the number of pi electron is 6? You can consider 4 for the 2 double bond. And these 2 extra pi electron are given due to the presence of anion. So anion gives extra 2 pi electron. So total they are having a 6 number of pi electron. So they follow the Huckel's rule. Right? Okay, as you can also statement in the Huckel's rule, there is a 4n plus 2. So n is equal to 1 number, because there is a 1 ring system are there. So 4 into 1, 4 plus 2, it is a 6 number. So number of delocalized pi electron is 6, right? So you can also vice versa cross check that. Okay, same example with the cationic. As there is a cationic, there is a no extra 2 pi electrons are there. So also you can see in the structure, first it is a cyclic in nature. Second one, it should be a planar. So it is a planar, right? Third one is a continuous delocalizations are available. Why? Because all the carbons are sp2 hybridized. Again, same thing. But the last, it does not follow the Hucker's rule. Why? Because the pi electron is only 4. While in the case of anion, there is extra 2 pi electrons are attached. So it follows the Hucker's rule. While in case of cationic, there is a no extra pi electron. So that number of pi electron in case of cation is 4. So cyclopentadiene cation is not aromatic. Why? Cyclopentadiene anion is aromatic and cation is not aromatic. So you can directly show that. Specifically, number of cation and anion gives a changing in the aromatic nature. Right? Okay, next one is aromaticity and the six-member ring system. We all know benzene is a six-membered ring system. Yes, it is aromatic in nature. How they are aromatic in nature? First, it is a cyclic in nature, planar. Yes, it exhibit continuous delocalization of pi electron while all the carbons are pi electron or having a sp2 hybridized. And delocalized pi electron is 6 because they are having a 3 double bond. So each double bond gives a 2 pi electron. There are 3 double bond. So total number is 6. So benzene is aromatic in nature. Sometimes in an exam, you should give a comment. While benzene is aromatic, or give a justifications, benzene is aromatic in nature. Why benzene is aromatic in nature? Because benzene strictly follow all these 4 statement. That's why benzene is aromatic in nature. If benzene compound does not follow any one statement, it cannot be considered as aromatic, right? This is the justifications of that comment. Okay, so it's very important as per your exam point of view. Okay, next one is 7-member ring system, that is cycloheptatrine. You can see here, this is a structure of cycloheptatrine, right? So again, it is a cyclic in nature, it is a planar. It does not exhibit continuous delocalizations. Why? Same thing, 3-member, 5-member, there is having a 1 sp3 hybridized compound. Yes, so this is not continuous delocalizations. And last one, it obeys the Hucker rule. Why? Because the number of delocalized pi electron is 6 because of 3 double bond. So cycloheptatrine is not aromatic in nature because they cannot follow the third statement of the delocalization. Okay, another example of cycloheptatrine cation, which is also called as tropylenium ion. Okay, it is a cation. It means, again, cyclic in nature, planar, yes, and all the carbons are sp2 hybridized. Yes, and last one, obey the Hucker's rule. Why? Because the pi electron is 6. So cycloheptatrine cation is aromatic, right? And simple cycloheptatrine is not aromatic. You can see the difference, right? There is also given in the exam. You should have a justification for that. While cationic form is aromatic in nature, and simple cycloheptatrine is not aromatic. These are justifications of that. Okay, similar manner in the anion. So again, first 3 are same. Cyclic in nature, planar, that exhibit continuous delocalizations. Right? But the last one, that does not obey the Hucker's rule. Why? Because the number of pi electron is increased. At first they are having a 6 pi electron, but in case of anion they are having an extra 2 electron, that is 2, 6 plus 2, 8. So they having a 8 pi electron which does not follow the Hückel's rule. So anion is not aromatic. You can see same structure. Anion is not aromatic. Cation is aromatic. And simple compound is not aromatic. There is a difference between presence of pi electron in your structure. So you can consider that pi electron is how much responsible for the reactivity. Okay, next one is aromaticity of 8-membered ring system. So obviously 8-membered ring system, cyclooctatetracene, C8H8. It exists like this, non-plane, top-shaped structure are there. It is a cyclic in nature, yes, but it is a non-planar. It is not a planar in a nature, right? So it does not follow the second statement. Okay, third statement, they all are sp2 hybridized. Yes. Last one, they does not follow the Hückel's rule. Why? Because the pi electron is 8. Because they are having a 4 double bond. So each double bond having a 2 pi electron. So 4 double bond having a total 8 pi electron. So this 8 number is not in the list of Hückel's rule. It should be a 2, 6, 10. There is a no 8. Right? So that's why the cyclooctatetracene is not aromatic, as all the conditions are not satisfied. Right? Okay, another example of that anion, that is a dianion. See, this is a structure of cyclooctatetraenyl dianion. 2 minus are there. Okay, another for the aromaticity, it is a cyclic in nature. Yes, it's a planar in nature. It exhibits continuously localizations, and that obeys the Hückel's rule. Why they obey the Hückel's rules? You can see anions are there. So anion are having an extra electron pair, right? So main cyclooctatetraenyl gives a 8 pi electron plus 2 extra of this dianion. Total number of pi electron is 10. So as per the Hückel's rule, it follows the 2, 6 and 10. So it obeys the Hückel rule. Right? So this is just all we have give a brief introductions about the Hückel's rule, orbital structure, Kekulé structure and the different aromaticity of the different member ring system. 3-member ring system we have discussed. We have discussed 4-membered, 5-membered, 6-member, of course, the benzene ring system, 7-member, cyclopentane, 8-member, cyclooctane. These all are example, and they suggest that all the compound are not aromatic in nature. This is the justifications for that. Thank you.